This is Jared Horak for today's racingdigest.com. My today's Racing Digest video series continues. Friday, October 4th, Saturday, October 5th, we have some Breeders' Cup Win and You're In events. I'm going to do two from Keeneland on Friday and then two more for Saturday. Before we get to that, let's go back to last week's video. Last week, we did have a nice winner. We had Mirth in the Rodeo Drive Stakes. That was a Win and You're In for the Breeders' Cup Filly and Mare Turf. Mirth was the controlling speed, went wire to wire, paid $14.20, so a nice 6-to-1 winner last week's video for today's racingdigest.com. Let's see if we can get another winner, or hopefully more, because we're doing four races this week. Let's see if we can get some winners this week. And we'll begin Friday, October 4th, 2019. We're going to do the eighth race from Keeneland. It's going to be the Grade 2 Phoenix Stakes, 3-year-olds and up, 6 furlongs on the main track. This is a Breeders' Cup Win and You're In for the Breeders' Cup Sprint. And this race seems to have a lot of speed. Right off the bat, there's multiple speed horses. American Pastime, number one. You have Cove Blue, number two. So you have a lot of inside speed right there. Then you have Recruiting Ready, breaking from a middle post. You have the defending champion in this race, Promises Fulfilled, has a lot of speed. Heartwood, zip on by towards the outside. So there's a lot of horses that like to show speed in here. It seems to set up for an off-the-pace runner. Now, if a speed horse does win, I would think the Promises Fulfilled would be one of the most likely ones to shake off the other speed and keep on going. He is a defending champion. He's a pretty good sprinter, but I think that other speed's going to soften him up. Now, some of the horses to consider if that pace scenario falls apart, number 8 Engage is 8-to-1 on the morning line for trainer Steve Asmussen. Used to be in the Chad Brown barn as a 3-year-old. This one was pretty good for Chad Brown. Beat Promises Fulfilled once. Promises Fulfilled came back and beat that one a couple times last year. And then in his last start, he moved to the Steve Asmussen barn at Parks, the Ben Salem Stakes, stalked the pace, and he held on to win that one. So he does have some back class. He ran a decent race last time. He's got some tactical speed, but he's still going to have to move forward. That last win, if he ran that race here, it's not going to be good enough to win. And he's going to have to step it up a notch here. Now, Hog Creek Hustle, number 6, is the big late runner in here. He's 5-to-1 morning line. He's a 3-year-old. Likes to sit back. He gets involved very late. His last two starts were at 7 furlongs, so now he's cutting back a furlong. The biggest question here is going to be the distance, even more than the pace. The pace should set up for him, but he's been running 7 furlongs and getting there very late. Now, this is 6 furlongs, 1 furlong shorter. He'll be rolling in the stretch, but I think he might fall a bit short. But he's one that could be pretty reliable to finish at least third in here. Number 5, a Diamond Oops, 8-to-1 morning line. I considered picking him on top. He's cross-entered in the Grade 1 Chadwell Turf Mile at Keeneland on Saturday, October 5th. So we'll see which spot he goes to. I hope he goes in this race. He seems much improved. His last couple starts, very good. He had a big effort in the Smile Sprint, a Grade 3 at Gulfstream Park in June. Then he came back last time. He finished second. Imperial Hint won that one. Mitole was third. That was a Grade 1, the Vanderbilt at Saratoga on July 27th. He's got stalking speed. Obviously, his numbers in his last two jumped up. Good efforts in the graded stakes ranks. And look out for Diamond Oops from off the pace if he does run in this spot. I'm going to go with number 3, Whitmore. I've been torn on him whether he's tailing off. He's older. He's just not as good. And that's possible. But this race really does set up for him. Now, he won the Phoenix Stakes at Keeneland in 2017. And then he missed by a head to Promises Fulfilled in this race last year. So Whitmore's one that certainly likes this track. His recent form isn't great. He didn't run well in his last few races. He had some excuses. He wasn't on the good part of the track last time. 7 furlongs before that. He's much better at 6 furlongs. He is 8'6". It's really possible that he has lost a step, but he is fresh and he runs well fresh. He loves 6 furlongs. This race sets up for him. He has a lot of class. And I'm going to think that Whitmore can bounce back in this spot and run a big race. This is going to be my wagering strategy spotlight race. We're going to have the wagering strategies in this race, and we're going to make a win wager on number 3, Whitmore. We're going to play an exacta box with Whitmore and Diamond Oops, and then we're going to play an exacta with those two, number 3, Whitmore, and number 5, Diamond Oops, on top of number 6, Hog Creek Hustle, and number 8, Engage, and then a trifecta. We're going to put our top two on top, number 3, Whitmore, number 5, Diamond Oops. We're going to put all in second, and we're going to key number 6, Hog Creek Hustle, the best late runner in the field, in third. And if he can get up for a piece of it and one of our top choices win, we have the trifecta. Let's do Keeneland Race 9, the Grade 1 Alcibiades, and that one's also on Friday. For two-year-old fillies, a mile and a 16th on the main track. This is the Breeders' Cup Juvenile Fillies win and you're in race. And I started my Kentucky Oaks 2020 blog for todaysracingdigest.com. Had my first post earlier this week. So if you go over to todaysracingdigest.com, you can see my top five Kentucky Oaks 2020 contenders. I go through the history of the race, key preps, and all that. And you can find all that information at todaysracingdigest.com. But let's look at this race right now. This is my Fast Figs Spotlight race. I've been doing the Fast Figs each week for Today's Racing Digest for these videos. And the Fast Figs are a speed and class rating all rolled into one. It's been a very effective number for Today's Racing Digest. Very profitable, flat betting and in the exotics. So the Fast Figs have been doing very well. And you can learn more about the Fast Figs in the description in this video. And if you're interested in purchasing them, Fast Figs are $3 a card. Or you can get unlimited downloads, $39 for 30 days at todaysracingdigest.com. The Fast Fig Spotlight, as I said, that's this race. Let's pull up the Fast Figs for this race, and you'll see that Perfect Alibi has the best number at a 118, Michelin with a 115, Alondra has a 114, and then How Ironic, number 11, also has a 114. So those four horses have the top four Fast Figs, and Perfect Alibi with the highest number is going to be your morning line favorite as well. Let's give out my top four in here. We'll start with number 11, How Ironic. This one, 20-1 morning line. She's switching surfaces for trainer Vicky Oliver. She's been running in turf sprints. She is bred to handle a route of ground. As you saw that Fast Fig, she's got some competitive numbers, and if she can switch surfaces after a couple of turf sprints, not the greatest post, but you know, at 20-1, you might want to throw her in somewhere in the mix. Michelin, we mentioned that one. That one has 8-1 morning line odds. Already running route races two times, so that's a plus for her. So she's got that route experience in this race. They were on turf though, so now she's going to move to the main track. And I think more than anything else, if you look at her pedigree, maybe they ran her in those turf routes because they were running around two turns, not real necessarily the surface. It was more the distance. I think that was the key. They wanted to run her over a route of ground. She adds Lasix in this race. She has a nice dirt pedigree. Bernardini, a good dirt sire. And then Include is the dam sire. So lots of stamina, lots of dirt in that pedigree. Maybe Michelin at 8-1 can run a good race. Perfect Alibi is your morning line favorite, 5-2. She's making her fifth start. She has plenty of experience, and she's already won two graded stakes races for trainer Mark Cassie. She's been very determined. She's shown that she can be inside. She can bully her way through. She can overcome some bumping and some traffic. So that's what you want to see. And that's what we've seen from her in her last couple. She beat Frank's Roquette, was the favorite in those races, back-to-back times, and she offered good value. She's not going to offer that value today. This is her first start around two turns, but she's shown, you know, a lot of tenacity in those races, and she's going to be fighting hard throughout. And that brings us to the top two. Number six, a British Idiom, 4-1 morning line is going to be my second choice. So she did look good in her 6-furlong debut. That was at Saratoga for trainer Brad Cox. Now she's going to stretch out in distance, and the runner-up from her debut was the next out winner. So we'll see if she can handle a route of ground in here. Javier Castellano is going to ride back. If she can handle the distance and the pedigree is a little bit dicey on that, we'll have to see. But she showed a lot of promise in that debut. But I'm going to go with number four, Alondra. Now, Alondra is part of my Kentucky Oaks top five that I mentioned was at todaysracingdigest.com. Shug McGahee is the trainer here. Don't know how good she is. Certainly, she's only run one time, but it's not easy to win in the debut, 7 furlongs. But she did that, and she battled inside. The favorite came after her. It was an experienced horse, and she didn't have any experience as a first-timer inside 7 furlongs. She battled back, and she won that one, and she was pulling away. That was a nice effort in the debut. And also, Shug's first-time starters don't usually show the kind of speed that she showed, but there was one recently that did, and that was Code of Honor. Remember, Code of Honor won his debut wire-to-wire at Saratoga last summer, and he ends up one of the top 3-year-old colts in the land this year, and he's heading to the Breeders' Cup Classic now. He won the Jockey Club Gold Cup in the Travers. So we're not saying she's as good as Code of Honor. We don't know that yet, but excellent pedigree, excellent connections, a lot of promise here. And I think that she has the potential to be a good one for trainer Shug McGahee. Let's do Saturday, October 5th now. We're going to do the 7th race from Keeneland, the Grade 2 Thoroughbred Club of America Stakes, 6 furlongs for fillies and mares on the main track. This is the Breeders' Cup Filly Mare Sprint win in your in race. And I got this one down to my top 4 contenders. Number 4, Danuska, my girl, is the 4th choice. And she's the one to catch in here. She's pretty quick. She likes to go out there, set the pace. Flavian Pratt's going to ride. She's 4-for-5 at 6 furlongs. Come and catch her. She's a Southern California shipper. And California sprinters, when they ship east, they can be dangerous because that California speed is usually pretty good. Number 8, Chalon's going to be my 3rd choice. This one has finished 1st or 2nd in her last 10 starts. She's very consistent. She loves 6 furlongs. She was 2nd in all 3 of her starts at Keeneland in the past, and she missed by a head in the 2018 Thoroughbred Club of America Stakes. Now we get down to my top 2. Number 3, Spice Perfection is going to be my 2nd choice. She's a cowbred. She's won 2 Grade 1 races for trainer Peter Miller, the La Brea and the Madison Stakes at Keeneland. She's 2-for-2 at 6 furlongs. She's fresh, tactical speed. She's cutting back from 7 furlongs to 6 furlongs. But I'm going to go with number 1, Ours to Run, for trainer Larry Jones. She had a 6-race win streak snapped last time out when she was 2nd. She was actually 3rd in the Grade 2 Honorable Miss. She missed 2nd by a head in that race. Chalon was 2nd, my 4th choice in this race. Now she does run well fresh. She's 6-for-9 at 6 furlongs. Gabriel Saez gets aboard. He was 2-for-2 with her last year, so he only rode her twice. He won both times. She's been pointing to this race since July. She's an inside stalker from post 1. She's a Louisiana bred mare. This is her toughest spot yet, but she was very competitive with graded stakes races, the stakes company at Saratoga last time. She has a Keeneland bullet workout for this on September 30th. There's a lot of positives here, and she'll probably offer a bit of value as well. Finally, we're going to do Keeneland Race 9 for Saturday, October 5th, the Grade 1 Breeders Futurity Stakes for 2-year-olds, 1 1/16 on the main track. This is the Breeders' Cup win and you're in for the Breeders' Cup Juvenile. And just as I mentioned with my Oaks, my Kentucky Derby 2020 blog has started at todaysracingdigest.com, posted my first exceptional 11, and some of them are in this race, including my top-ranked colt right now. And you can read that first blog at todaysracingdigest.com. Covers my top 11, goes back the last 20 years of the Derby, talks about the key preps, where you want to run as you're traveling on the road to the Derby. But in this race, there's quite a few contenders in here. Number 2, By Your Side, is one that you certainly consider. He's the only graded winner in this race. He won the Grade 3 Sanford at Saratoga. Then last time in the slop in the Grade 1 Hopeful, didn't run well. We don't know if he's going to be a sprinter or a stretch out type horse. We're going to find out in this spot. A lot of them, we're going to find out if they can handle 2 turns. He's got that experience, that stakes experience. He's probably ready to route. He has 2 Keeneland bullets. Don't know how much value he's going to offer. Number 8, Ajaaweed, is one that you can look at. He improved 2nd time out to break his maiden. That was in a 1-mile race at Belmont Park on September 11th. Kieran McLaughlin's the trainer. And I like the pedigree. On the top, he has Curlin's the sire. The dam side has some speed. That's a good blended speed stamina type pedigree. Wouldn't be surprised if this one handled the distance. Trainer Mark Cassie has a couple in here. Number one, Tap It to Win, is the first one we'll talk about. He switched from turf to dirt. He broke his maiden at 6 furlongs at Saratoga on August 24th, and the runner-up was the next out winner. Promising route pedigree. Tap It the sire, Medallia d'Oro the dam sire. He's got early pressing speed. The inside post should be forwardly placed. Mark Cassie's other runner, number 3, Enforceable. He added blinkers. He broke his maiden. That was his 4th start. That was at 1 1/8 at Saratoga on August 22nd. So he's already gone 1 1/8. That's very early for a 2-year-old to be gone that far. He's Mohaman's full brother. Mohaman was one that I liked on the Derby trail. He finished 4th in the Kentucky Derby when he was a 3-year-old. And with those 2 back-to-back route starts, he's got plenty of stamina, plenty of bottom underneath him, and he could end up trying to make a threat, make a run in the stretch. This number 6, Maxfield, is going to be my 2nd choice. He seems interesting. He overcame a slow start. He broke from post 2, an 11-horse field, in a 1-mile race at Churchill Downs in his career debut, and that was a nice effort. September 14th, overcame that slow start, rallied, won the race nicely. Looks like he has a lot of promise. Very classy, a Godolphin pedigree. Godolphin's the owner here. Street Sense the sire, Bernardini the dam sire. certainly bred to get better as he gets older. Don't know if this is quite the spot. Maybe they run here. We'll see what he does. If he runs a big race here, he could be in the Breeders' Cup Juvenile. If not, maybe they do the Kentucky Jockey Club Stakes at Churchill Downs next. Either way, this is one you want to watch on the road to the Kentucky Derby. And then finally, I am going to go with number 10, a Gouverneur Morris for trainer Todd Pletcher. This one is a $600,000 purchase. And he looked really good in that debut. He tracked the pace. He was the big favorite. He won by 9 lengths. But that was 5.5 furlongs in the slop at Saratoga on September 2nd. Now we'll have to see. Can he run the same race on a dry track? Maybe he just won despite the wet track last time. Does he want to go two turns? He's got the outside post. There's a lot that we have to learn about this one. A lot of promise, though. And he's my very early number one Kentucky Derby contender right now. So Gouverneur Morris is going to be my top choice in here. I think he's going to sit a good trip up on the pace under Javier Castellano, and maybe he can tuck in, stalk the pace, and hopefully he can go two turns. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up, subscribe to my YouTube channel, make some comments in the comment section. Who do you like in some of these Breeders' Cup Win and Year End stakes races at Keeneland? We'll talk about some Belmont. Throw some comments in there. I'm going to look at the Belmont, the Santa Anita races, all the stakes races this weekend. So make some comments in that comment section. And then until next week, good luck at the races.